exams coming closer and closer and closer. Some of you may be getting very tensed up. Some of you may be saying, it's okay, yaar, I'll deal with it. But in either case, you'll be having a lot of people who will be telling you, study hard, study hard, study more. Actually, I don't believe in that, you know. I don't think studying hard gets you results. I think studying smart gets you results. What do you mean by this thing called study smart? It means being able to know when to study. There are times when you need to study, there are times when you don't need to study. It means to know where to study. Oh my God, it makes so much difference where and how you are studying, you know that. And then comes the techniques. How to study, there are different ways of studying. What suits you should be the one that you should pick up. Once you do that, then you become selective. What to study, when. After you have mastered this, or while you are mastering it, there will be one question that you need to ask yourself, that is, why to study? Why study at all? Is it just to get that stupid extra marks? No, it's much more than that. So what we are going to do is, we are going to take you through this process of when to study, where to study, how to study, what to study, and why to study. If you understand these concepts, believe me, you'll not only do much better in your exams, you'll have true learning taking place. What goes in will remain permanently with you. Okay? Best of luck. Now let me talk to you about when to study. Ideal time to start studying is right now. Actually, it was yesterday. We all procrastinate. Doesn't matter if you've lost time, doesn't matter if exams are coming pretty close. But now is the time to really get going. Don't tell yourself, I've got 3 months more, I've got 1 month more, I've got so many days more. No. Inevitably, there's that Murphy's Law. No, if something has to go wrong, it will go wrong. And that's what happens when you're preparing for your exams. There will be some wedding, there will be some party, you'll fall sick, somebody will have somewhere, and you'll realize that you're losing that many days, okay? So start at the earliest and tell yourself that you have 20-30% less number of days than you actually have for the exams, calculated that way. Now, look at what is what we refer to as your biological clock. There's a clock inside you which keeps telling you when you are fresh and up and all that, when you are a little down and out. There are some of us who are morning people, there are some of us who are daytime people, there are some of us who are evening people, there are some of us who are midnight people. You find out what you are good at. Once you find out those different timings and when you could do that, then study the most boring, the most difficult, the most important subjects at a time when you are fresh. The time when you're feeling down and out and this and that, don't neglect it. Don't say, I'm not going to study. Do study, but do some revision. Catch up with some of the easy subjects. Just read something which you have already read earlier or something of that sort. Then there's one more thing about when to study. Remember that you need to take breaks. Not everybody can study at a stretch for 2 hours, 3 hours. Again, it's your biological clock. Some of us can sit for 2 hours and study. Some of us 1 hour. Some of us 20 minutes. Doesn't matter. When you feel that after 20 minutes my concentration goes down, take a break. Even a 2 minute break helps. Time is very, very important. You'll start getting tensed up. But those 2 minutes will help you to concentrate for another maybe 20 minutes or 40 minutes or whatever it is. Okay? At the same time, remember, don't study when you're sleepy, that is obvious, you know that. Don't study when you're hungry, and don't study when your stomach is absolutely full. In fact, during these days, try and see if you can have smaller and more often meals. If you have been used to having 3 meals, make it 4 meals, make it 4.5 meals. So your stomach is never empty. If you had breakfast at 7 and you go on studying till 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, take a break at 11, have a snack to eat. If you had just had your lunch and you're feeling absolutely full, go around for a walk or something of that sort. The other thing to remember is that if you have something pending, some task is to be done, I have to get going on something or I have to do something, either go and finish it off and come back so that you're free in your mind, or if it is not possible to do it right now, then jot it down. Write it on a piece of paper, take a piece of paper, write down, after this I have to go before the shops close and buy this, write it down, put it away in one corner. Now you know that when you are through with your studies, that task will be there, you will not forget the thing. Talking about time, a lot of people say, I didn't get time to revise, I didn't get enough time to practice those sums or something. Nobody has time management issues. We only have priorities. Remember that everybody has 24 hours. But what you prioritize is what comes up. And then lastly, one of the most important things that we forget is, what are your time wasters? Please make a list of what are your time wasters. Most of us are not aware how much time we spend on the phone. In a day, if you think that you spend only 30 minutes on the phone, when you actually check out, pull out your phone and check that day how much time I have spent on the phone, you'll be shocked to realize that it was 72 minutes instead of 30. So list down all your time wasters and each one of them start cutting down. Let me not spend too much time on the phone. Let me not spend too much time on this. List that down and do it at least till the exams are over. Once the exams are over, you'll have all the time in the world to do whatever you want. Enjoy yourself. But this is the time for you to focus your time, to control your time, and give the best shot.